aggressively and they don't rush into each other, right? Now, you may ask yourself why, and it looks like, it looks weak, right? It doesn't look fun. But bear in mind that you're wearing only what you've got on yourself now. You're facing me, and I'm holding this in my hand. Would you like to just run into me and try to hit me with your sword, yeah?
No.
I'm not so sure about that. So the real fights were actually a lot more cautious. Remember, in these times you don't have a modern medicine, you don't have penicillin, you don't have antibiotics. You get cut, you might go really bad, you might lose your arm, or hand, or leg, just from a scratch. Stop. Go back into that situation. Now, what happened before? Before, Thomas gained a few advantages over his opponent. His weapon is on the top of the opponent's weapon. That's the one thing. If Peter wants to drag his weapon up, it's always more difficult than put it down, right? Going that way is more natural, gives you more strength. So, if you manage to place your weapon on the top of your opponent's weapon, you got one advantage. Now, the second advantage Thomas got here is when you put your blade against the flat of opponent's blade. Right? Now, in a situation that he strikes Peter's head, Peter would strike at his legs or his arm. And that would result in two dead bodies and nobody wins. Right? So next time you see a fight on a screen, right, bear in mind that if you kill your opponent when he runs his sword through you, you win only for 5-10 minutes, maybe a day, and then you die. Then you die anyway. So bearing that in mind, think about what they do here as a life or death situation, and then you understand why they're coming at each other really, really carefully. Okay guys, if you want to manage to land a hit on somebody's head, stop it. Plays a very active role in the combat. It's not carried as a solid wall in front of the warrior. He actually uses it to open up his opponent's defense, make a way for the sword to strike.
Oh, I think that's a good one.